Welcome to another exciting tutorial. Today we are going to create a mini game in Java. It will look like this. This is a flying Nyan cat. Every time we hit the cat gets faster and loses one of their lives. A cat has 7 lives, of course. 3 and... Yes, we did it. Okay, let's start with the code. Like always, we need a new Java class. We let the main class be created automatically and call the new class Nyan. Okay, I move the main class down first. First, we have to import the packages needed for GUI programming. We extend our class from the class JFrame because we want to build a window. Let's start with the required variables. We need a container for the components, a JLabel for the image, a dimension object to read our screen size. An integer life counter for the cat's life. These are of course 7. An integer for the cat's speed. An icon object. And a string to output the life counter. We start with the constructor. The container C is assigned to the content pane. Now we make our window transparent. We remove the border of the window with sat undecorated true. And set the background color transparent. I set the size of our window with the size of our cat image. Now we can create our cat picture. The picture is directly in our project folder, so I only have to enter the name here. Then we create a JLabel and give it the text of the cat's life and our picture with the attribute center. For the text, I create a new font, monospaced, with size 55 in bold. I also center the text horizontally. Finally, we have to add the label to our container. And that's it for our constructor. Let's test our program by creating a new object in the main class and making it visible. This works perfectly. The cat runs on the spot. So, now comes the core of our project. Therefore, I write myself a new function and call it run. We determine the starting position of the cat for x and y. Also two boolean values to find out where the cat is on the screen. Now it's about the main loop in which our program runs. As long as the life counter is greater than or equal to 0, it will be executed. We let the loop sleep for 10 milliseconds at the beginning of each run, otherwise the cat would jump across the screen too fast. We also have to throw the exceptions at this point, but catch it later. After sleeping, the position for X and Y is redefined each time. Next, we have to set the direction in which the cat should fly. For this, I write myself 4 if instructions. If the y-axis is larger than the height of our screen, minus 200 for the cat picture, then the y boolean should be true. And if the x-axis is smaller than minus 200, the y boolean should be false. The same for the x-axis. If x is greater than the screen width, minus 200 for the cat image, then the x boolean should be false. Else, x is less than or equal to minus 200, then x boolean is false. Oh, we have a small error here. At the first if statement, everything should of course be called y. Now the boolean are determined, depending on where the cat is on the screen. Now we have to determine how the cat moves in which direction. If y boolean is true, then y should be set minus speed, so that the cat moves from the bottom to the top. Otherwise, y plus speed from top to the bottom. If the x boolean is true, then x minus speed. The cat moves from right to left. Otherwise, x plus speed. The cat moves from left to right. At the end of the loop, the J-label text is clear and the explosion GIF is shown. We wait 1.8 seconds until the GIF is played and close the program. We add the run function to our main class and catch exceptions with try and catch. Finally, we need a mouse listener to reduce the cat's life. We extend the class of mouse adapter and implement the function mouse pressed. When the mouse is pressed on the cat, the text of the J label is placed on the life counter and reduced by 1. And the speed is increased by 2. Now we add the mouse listener to our container. In line 71, the X boolean must of course be true. 2 times false make no sense here. We start our program and it runs. every time you click on the cat, the life counter reduces and the cat gets faster. After 7 lives, the cat finally explodes. We can also open the program several times and hunt many cats. That's it. If you like what you saw, please leave me a comment and a like. And follow my channel for more tutorials. Thanks for watching.